constellation is no stranger to loss. Our own founder left on an expedition and never returned. It is easy to talk about the glory and excitement of breaching into the unknown, of lighting the darkness. But it is harder to stare into the face of the cost. That all of our progress is built on top of the lives of those who dared. And that we owe them the courage to continue our work in their memory.
Thank you, Sarah. If anyone else would like to say a few words. Thank you. If anyone else wants to say something.
My boy. I've lost my boy. Should be me buried in the ground. All I ever wanted to do was protect him. But no, he was out the door as soon as he could. Away from his mother, so, away from
instead,
Akila,
I thought I would away from me. That gave me comfort a long time ago. Is God real? The more proper question would be, is reality divine? Existence itself is a mystery which yearns to be uncovered. What is goodness but a comparison to the good? What is existence but a participation in being? For where the diversity of the universe inspires awe and wonder, it exists only in contrast to a simplicity so pure that it may only be understood as primordial and even divine. Our essence is what was imagined by its mind, but what we consider imagining and what we consider mind are in fact so far beyond our understanding that even these metaphors are like the tiny white caps on a massive searching sea. There's more, but those are the parts that speak to me the most. Thank you.
That was really thoughtful, Mateo. Thank you. Does anyone else want to say anything?
I don't often speak about what I believe in. Seems so redundant with how I live. But death is one of those occasions where it's hard not to look inward. Our friend is gone. There's no afterlife or second meetings. No God in heaven that is curating a perfect ending for them. So it's up to us. We are what lives on. The pain of loss inspires us to greater action, then that is the good that comes from all this. Humanity is what truly creates our world. We are the ones that judge things to be good or evil, joyful or mournful. Let us take responsibility for it. Let us remember what we have lost.
Walter, are you part of the House of Enlightenment? I never knew that.
Yes, well, I like to keep some things private.
You all might not like thinking about this, but when we die, everything about us breaks down, decomposes, gets eaten up by insects and microbes. Or due to the lack of a biosphere, we are simply carried away by space and time until we sizzle in a distant sun's corona or get pulled in some gravitational field and coalesce with other debris. Not comforting, huh? But I disagree. Do you know what I find uncomfortable? The thought that after I die, the universe is just going to stand still forever. Could you imagine? The fact is that the universe goes on. The life goes on. The things do not just sit still. That right there is the comfort that I need. Yeah, we die. And some people go way before they should. But the universe doesn't care. Not because it's evil, but because it's infinite, ever expanding. And who wouldn't want to be a part of infinity, even if it's just for a short while? Listen, we don't worry about ourselves before we were born, do we? Of course not. We emerge from the universe as we return to it. And for one beautiful moment, we are here together.
Yes. That certainly was an interesting perspective, Barrett.
Hey, how are you holding up? Take some time for yourself, okay? Plenty of rooms to sit down in if you need to be alone for a while. We'll get through this. It might feel like everything's falling apart, but that's why we need to stick together. We all have to get through this our own way. Don't worry about me. Really, I'll be fine. We should have a talk. When you take care of yourself. A loss is always hard. Constellation will get through this together. Like always.
Chat for a bit? Normally, I hate talking to people at funerals. But, well. You don't believe in the afterlife, do you? I mean, this might be the worst time to bring it up, but... You're a member of the House of Enlightenment? Funny. We've worked together all this time. And I never thought to ask. I suppose you might think I joined because it lets me off the moral conundrum of having a god count my credits when I die. But the truth is, I believe in an individual's place to make a difference. What is wealth if you can't do something with it? What is free will if we don't ultimately answer to ourselves? Well, I've taken up enough of your time.
I hope this is all okay. Between fixing things up and sending out messengers and getting all the paperwork done, it's not much. Good. Good. Sorry, if I talk any longer, I'm gonna start crying. Could you excuse me?
You know, what you're feeling right now is a chemical reaction whose evolutionary goal is promoting social cohesion. Never seems to work for me. No matter how many times I do this, I feel less attached, not more. Well. Well, look at us. Two lone wolves howling at the moon on the same night. You know, if there's one piece of advice I can actually give you, it's that lost loved ones have a way of coming back to you. One day you'll be sweeping out some old shelf or digging through a desk, and there it'll be. Some old paperweight of theirs. Or a piece of jewelry they gave you, half jokingly. Theoretically, of course. Maybe I like knowing no matter how far I run to the edges of space, someone is going to find their way back to me.
It almost feels wrong to be grieving.
Hey, Captain.
Selfish.
Can I talk with you for a bit?
No amount of tears will bring the dead back. It's just easier to feel guilty, if you'll excuse me.
I am told these types of gatherings are a sad occasion. That assumption appears to be correct. I appreciate you verifying my analysis, although I am certain my thanks will do little to improve your current psychological trauma. If you would like, though, I can add some consoling language to my programming. Very well.
You one of Sam's Constellation people? Lillian Hart. He probably never mentioned me. I mean, I try not to talk about him, so... I'm sorry. That was a terrible thing to say. Cora's mother. Sam's ex. God, I'm rambling.
Look, I don't know who I should speak to about this, but Cora and I talked, and she's coming to live with me.
She talked about you all the time. But right now, she just needs to get away from all the reminders of Sam.
We'll be leaving soon. So say your goodbyes to her, if you like.
Drink? Pour one out to the blackest sea? Two old friends. May their ghosts go past the edges of space, to the great beyond. Aye.
Everyone is in mourning. I understand, but I cannot quite share in their emotion. I have seen death. I have lost people I considered close. But this is... it is not the same. I cannot explain why. I am not sure I am making sense. Thank you.
If you are free soon,
thank you. right, Robin? Fine. You win. I'll ask this random stranger that paid my way it is, then. Fine. You know what, Robin? Fine. You win. I'll ask... I just can't catch a break today.
Unexpected.
Doing water. But honestly, let's get a
will
second
you
opinion,
look at that?
Shall we?
Thought there was
Walter
no cards
and
left
just
in the
discussing
deck
the expenses
that could pull one over
incurred during the attack.
Yet here you are.
No,
like a
I
damn
was explaining
ghost.
That there's nothing to discuss. It's been taken care of.
It seems that Walter has taken it upon himself to cover the costs of the repairs to both the lodge and the eye, as well as any expenses relating to the... to the funeral services.
Sam was a good man. It's the least I could do. Well, it's not about looking for thanks. I just... it needed to be done, that's all.
Well, I can't thank
forgot
you enough,
forgot to check
Walter.
The math on a few equations.
Sarah?
The brain's long gone. Found one. We argue easy as a needle in this stack. Hope those powers you're getting to overinflate you. Got enough egos in Constellation.
I can best contribute to our work.
Thank you.
Captain, hello again. I was uncertain you would return.
Well, isn't this a surprise?
Gave up my room in the lodge, Sondre. The eyes showing signs over another one of those big anomalies. Here, catch a smile.
I'm sorry. Heat leeches can turn into what?
Terramorphs. Giant carapace-encrusted tanks.